Heavenly Father, we thank you. We honor your name this morning. Thank you for gathering us together again. Thank you, God, for waking us up to a new day, a new week, just to receive your blessings, to receive your instruction this morning. We are not just gathering anywhere. You say that we have come to Mount Zion, that we have come to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem. We have come into a company of innumerable company of angels, God. You tell us in your word that this is your general assembly, the church of the living God, of the firstborn of God. We thank you, God, that in this place, oh God, we come to our God who is the judge of all, that we come to the spirit and to the spirits of just men made perfect, that today, my Lord, that is what you're gathering us for, that every time we gather together as your children, Holy Spirit, make this reality a reality in our own lives. Make us begin to see ourselves as such. That when we gather together, that is who God sees. And so we thank you, my Father. We honor you for this great honor that you have afforded us, even to partner with you, to come and co-labor with you in this world. So as we begin this meeting, we give it to you. We honor you. We thank you for calling us to you. And this morning, as you give us instructions, may we have ears that hear and eyes that open up to see. And that be willing to do the things that we learned this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You're welcome in the presence of God this morning. And so let us go before the Lord with rejoicing and singing and praise his holy name.
I have made you too small in my eyes, oh Lord. But me close to you. Never let me go.
Amen. Amen. We thank God for that wonderful time of worship. And today we have no general prayers, being Monday. So we will go directly into our scripture reading for today. Today's scripture reading is taken from the book of 2 Peter, chapter 1, verse 12 to 21. 2 Peter 12, verse 21. 12 to 21. 2 Peter 1, 12 to 21. Sorry. And our brother Frank is going to read for us.
Good morning, all. Shall we hear the word of God? It's taken from 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 12 to 21, prophecy of scripture. So I'll always remind you of these things, even though you know them and are firmly established in the truth. So I'll always remind you of these things, even though you know them and are firmly established in the truth you now have. I think it is right to refresh your memory as long as I live in the tent of his body, because I know that I will soon put it aside, as our Lord Jesus Christ has made clear to me. And I'll make every effort to see that after my departure, you will always be able to remember these things. Verse 16, for we did not follow cleverly devised stories when we told you about the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ in power. But we were eyewitnesses of his majesty. He received honor and glory from God the Father when the voice came to him from the majesty glory, saying, "This is my son, whom I love. With him I'm well pleased." We ourselves heard his voice, this voice that came from heaven when we were with him on the sacred mountain. Verse 19. We also have prophetic message as something completely reliable. And you will do well to pay attention to it, as to a light shining in the dark place until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Above all, you must understand that no prophecy of scripture came about by the prophet's own interpretation of things. Verse 21, for the prophecy never had its origin in the human world, but prophets, though human, spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Thanks for reading the word of God. And now we're ready for our charge. It will be brought to us by Pastor Tunji. You're welcome, Pastor Tunji.
Praise the Lord. God is a good God. Thank God for this morning. Thank God for moving us forward day by day. The Bible says the path of the just is as a shining light. It shines more and more unto the perfect day. So we give God glory for today and the beauty of God that is reserved for us. Now, I intended to wrap up growing in the knowledge of God on Friday, but I wasn't in the program. So I'll quickly do that today. We've magnified the place of growth and the knowledge of God. And we're admonished to give all diligence to this. And the things we need to have, paying attention to, building up in our lives. He said, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, moral excellence. We talked about that. And he said, to virtue, knowledge, and to knowledge, temperance, and to temperance, patience. Or perseverance, or doggedness, or steadfastness. You know, we talked about that on Thursday, how we need to know to persevere. The Bible says, let patience have a perfect work. I know there are many of us counting time with God. For how long? How far would this go? Oh, God. Okay, but faith never gives up. Faith can't even see the other side. Glory to God. Then to patience, we talk of godliness. staying, not just staying on, but staying true with God. In worship, in doing all that we know to do in our covenant practices, in walking in the light of His word, and pressing, like Paul the Apostle says, I press towards the mark. Then to godliness, we talked also about brotherly kindness, affection. You know, they asked the Lord Jesus Christ, which is the great commandment, and He said, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy might, with every of your being. And He said, the second is like unto it, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. He said, against these two, there is no law. Nothing can stand against these two. On these two hang all the law and the prophets. And that's why He said to brotherly kindness and love. And like we said, brotherly kindness as to a brother in the faith. Love just takes it everywhere. Glory to God. We talked about all this. Love, dealing with people that are not even of the faith. You know, Jesus was giving the parable, who then is your neighbor? You know, the Jews passed, the priests passed. It has to be the Samaritans that they don't even relate with that help the man. So we talked about all that. And we continue today in wrapping it up. And the beauty of what we are looking at today is the statements that some of the statements we just read. Or perhaps we have read before. 2 Peter 1:8 says something significantly interesting. He said, for if these things be in you and abound, I like that, they make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. They make you. I've always loved that word make, because it's a manufacturer's word. Bringing things together, they make you. So those things become the raw materials. They transform you. They mature you. We've used a lighter word, they change you. We read that scripture, we are being changed from glory to glory. So you see, changes don't just come except we put practical effort in hiding all these things as he stated. You can write them on a big plate and put somewhere where you see, and you see how far you're going in each of them. It is in the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ, in our growth of the same, you know, walking in the light of His word and making effort in seeing various growth in various aspects of our lives. That these things being put together see to our transformation. They make you fruitful. You become proof producers. God is not just interested in calling ourselves His children where there is no fruit to show for it. You know, you read it in Luke. He said, these 3 years I come seeking fruit on this tree and find none. Cut it down. Like I said, you will not be cut down. Nothing to show for it. You're still that old self, nagging self, complaining self, you know, talking trash, no faith at work. All those things you must see, elements of growth, and pursue after it. You know, one thing we said about fruit is that fruit is always visible. It's always visible. And fruit bears the character of the tree to which it is connected. So if you say you are a child of God, a member of His body, but we can't see His fruits of righteousness, His fruits of godliness, His fruit of faith, His fruit of brotherly kindness, His fruit of patience, and all this we can't see in you, then there's a big question there. To whom are you connected? The character of God So, Jesus said, I am the vine and my Father is the husbandman. And every branch in me that beareth fruit. Okay, you say you are fruit, but what kind of fruit? Because by their fruits we shall know them. You can measure your growth by these things. And we said something, I think maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago when we're touching on fruits, because fruit is always for the benefits of somebody else. So if you are the one marking yourself fruitful and others can't testify to the same, that's where the problem is. What kind of fruits are you producing? Because that will tell us the kind of tree you are attached to. As we pick up on this year, I say the race has started, then let us run the race that is set before us. Begin to charge yourself because it's all about pleasing God. He that sent me is always with me. My Father has not left me alone because I do those things that please Him. You set that goal for yourself, checking yourself, motivating yourself, pushing yourself to seek to know. He said, I set myself to seek to know. It will not come to you. You will sit down. You will make effort. He said, oh, son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this scroll. That's Ezekiel 6. Show him a scroll. He said, then I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat. You see the combination? You won't force your mouth open. Let's go there. I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat this scroll. Ezekiel. Yeah, that's Ezekiel 3, verse 2. Verse 1 says, moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this roll, and go speak unto the house of my Israel. There is what you eat first before you speak. There is what you take in first before you manifest. That's why they came to Jesus, the Lord Jesus, one day. They said, your disciples are eating fruit without washing their heads. He said, you people are just so religious. You mind what is not important. He said, it's not what goes into a man that defies him, but what comes out. So something goes in and it will manifest. Eat this scroll, he says. He says, so I opened my mouth and he cursed me to it. That means when you are studying this book, you have to be there going through it. Then he, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, begins to open it up to you. He cursed me. Let me see that in other translations. So I opened my mouth, he says, and he fed me the scroll. Let's see another one here. He gave me the scroll to eat. Good. So I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat that roll. And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat it. You all know the process. You put food in your mouth, you chew it, take it in. Then the belly begins to eat. You know what I mean? To what we call digestion today. The digestive process, it begins to work on it and then take the nutrients into different parts of the body that makes you grow. The process is the same with the word. But without your sitting down, without your seeking knowledge, without your committing yourself to that path, we talk of believers, meetings of people have just in the pleasure of your home, but you just don't feel like we have many meetings like you. That's all that your life is. And all that. You strive to know. You get books, you listen to messages, you create time to pray, you make yourself. You make yourself. Cause thy belly to eat it. And not only that, fill thy bowels, he says, with this role. It's pretty much the same thing Job tells us. Acquaint now thyself with him and be at peace. I believe that's Job 22, 21. And good shall come unto you. He said, but receive, I pray thee, the law from his mouth and lay up. That means fill it up. And lay up his word in your heart. Fill thy bowels with it. Then did I eat it, because you will still have to eat it. And it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. And then God said to me, son of man, you are loaded now. I'm paraphrasing it. Go get thee unto the house of Israel and speak with. Not just speak my words. No, speak with. Check that scripture. Speak with my words. That means you have been impacted. You have been transformed. You have eaten it. Your belly has taken it in. It has become one with you. It's one. It's just like any food you eat. Look, this is flesh, but this is the result of all manner of food that I've been eating all these years. The same with you. The energy you carry, the strength you carry, everything is now one with you. You don't sip on the jam on my face or see chicken on your face. No. Your belly has eaten it. And if you're not eating it, we see it. Your cheeks will be flat and inside. Your eyes will be all out there. They say, this man is not eating well. So go eat well. The word of God. And he said, go speak with. Not just go speak my word. No, go speak with my words. What you have been impacted with, the energy you have received, the power, everything, now go manifest it. That's what he says. Go speak with my words. Your story must change this year for good. That means you are going to begin to look more and more like him. That we just sang in that song today. I'm chasing after you. That's Marie's song. I'm chasing after you just to be closer to you, to be more like you. Do you have that passion of heart? I want to be more like you, Lord. I want to be more like you. So we had all these things. Have us transformed. We are praying any. I know you have a lot of prayers you want to pray today, but one of Lord, I want to be more like you. But look at verse 9. Oh my God, I've transformed. Verse 9 says, but he that lacketh these things, I'm back to 2 Peter 1, sorry. He that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, short sighted. And I've forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. He says, I'm a Christian, so what? You lack these things. You are not driving yourself after them. You are not growing in them. Say, you are blind. Cannot see afar off. He would lack these things. Forgotten the kind of things he was brought out for. That means if you don't add those qualities, if I don't add those qualities, I'm blind, short-sighted, forgotten where I even came from. Short-sighted means just short thinking short-term. Thinking short-term. You're not thinking right. You're not looking at the big picture. You know, eternity must always be in view. So if you lack these things, but if you have them, that's my concentration today. You become fruitful. Life becomes meaningful. So, how much of them do you have? Are we loaded of these virtue, knowledge, temperance, brotherly kindness, godliness? No, that we have read. Jesus paid a big price for us. It must not be in vain. Remember, our salvation is seed form, and seed must be made to grow. Must be made to grow. There is a lot of effort that is put on the seed to grow. Can you say you are growing in God? You are seeing those changes. You're seeing those additions that people are appreciating your faith and Christianity. And you yourself know. And you are still pursuing it. He that lacketh these things is blind and is so short-sighted. But it has had these things will be fruitful. They shall not be barren or fruitful. It will be fruitful, productive in the work of the Lord. A new year is before us. Let's get going. And let's not forget where we are coming from. But let's keep looking forward. If I may comprehend that for which I am apprehended, he says. I want to be more like you. I want to be full of you. I want to reflect you. I want the world, when they see me, they know they are seeing you. When they hear me, they know they are hearing you. But all these are products of growth. Then I opened my mouth, and he caused me to eat. And he said, not only eat, make your belly eat it and fill yourself. So we keep searching. We keep searching. We keep learning. And we keep doing. We do. The change begins to come from glory to glory. From glory to glory. Looking more and more like him. They took knowledge of them. Oh, they have been with Christ. We can see him at work. We can see the fruit of it in them. What do people see of you? Before we even go far, you are husband and wife. What do your wife see of you? What do your husband see of you? Those are people closest to you. Jesus is Lord. May that change your heart longs for keep coming day by day. Transforming us. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. That ye may prove, that's what he says, what is that good and perfect will of God over to you. Over to you. Let's go into our personal prayer time this morning. Remember I said, well, as far as I'm being led by the Spirit on this, that's the way we go. To pray your way through this year yourself first, before we start putting through general prayers. You know you. He said, no man knows the thing of a man save the spirit of a man that is in him. You know you, so put it all out. The changes you want, the things you want. Your desires and aspirations, we put all it out before the Lord. So let's go before the Lord in our personal moment with God this morning. Also asking for more of him, and then we'll be back together shortly. Jesus is Lord.
Thank you.
Thank God for his word that has come to us this morning. We give him all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. It's amazing how each and every day we hear the word of God, and daily the word of God ministers unto us. You know, it's amazing how pastor explained the word of God as true food, something that has to be eaten. And I pray that you and I we receive this revelation and see the word of God as true food for our souls and our spirit. It says, moreover, he said unto me, Son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this scroll, and go speak unto the house of Israel. Eat the word of God. Eat the word of God. Eat the word of God. And I pray that the Lord himself will help you and I, that this year we will see the word of God as truly the daily bread of God, the true daily bread. That just as every day we eat breakfast, we eat lunch, and we eat dinner, same way daily we will see the word of God as the food of the spirit, as the food of the spirit. And we will study, we will spend time in the word of God to nourish our spirits, to nourish our souls, to nourish us in the spirit. He says, bodily exercise profiteth little, but spiritual exercise profiteth all. He said all. He didn't say just much. Much, all, everything. When we build our spirits up, we gain mastery over all things. See, the Bible says in all things, we are conquerors. In all things, which means that we fight to conquer, but we are conquering, we are victorious. But there is a fighting there, and we need to build our spiritual strength to be able to stand against the fiery darts of the evil one, the evil thoughts that come, the fiery thoughts. You know, Satan sending little seeds of fear into us. You know, a friend was telling me that, you know, he went to the bathroom to you know, just to urinate, and he said he saw blood in his urine, and he called his doctor and this and that. I'm like, if you're a Christian, if you pee and you see blood in your urine, thank God you are filled with the blood of Jesus Christ. You overflowing blood, and that blood is coming out. Thank God for it. So, oh, that is the blood of Jesus, all the communion you've been taking. Your body is a temple of God. Let the word of God speak to us. When we are filled with the word of God, when we face a challenge, that word of God comes very quickly to take over that situation. Fill yourself with the word of God. So things that, you know, unbelievers will see, and it will shake them, and they'll be afraid. You will see and you glorify God. You will give a new meaning to it. Don't see things and call them symptoms of sickness. Find a reflection of them in the word of God. Find a reflection of them in the word of God. Declare your body, my body is filled with Jesus Christ. My body is the temple of God. I don't have this sickness. I have Jesus Christ. Your doctor tells you, oh, hey, you have cancer. I said, no, I have Jesus. I don't have cancer. I have Jesus Christ. Because you know you have him. Because you've been eating that word of God. You are filled with the word of God. You are filled with Jesus Christ. You are filled with the word of God. You look at yourself in a mirror and you see the embodiment of Jesus Christ. You look at yourself. You look at your eyes and, oh, I have the eyes of Jesus. Don't say your eyes are dimming. The eyes of Jesus never dimmed. When you look at yourself and you see something that doesn't look right, say, no, no, you are not there. I have Jesus Christ. You confess Jesus in yourself. You fill yourself with the word of God. Soak yourself, empower yourself, fill yourself daily with the word of God. Soak yourself, eat the word of God. When you know, as Pastor was saying, when you see somebody who has eaten and well nourished, you can see that. They look so fresh, they look so nourished. So you and I, we need to feed on the word of God. Say, eat the scrolls, eat it into your body. Son of man, eat the word of God. Eat the daily bread. Jesus Christ said, I am the daily bread. He didn't say I'm the weekly bread, or he said I'm the Sunday bread. So I'm the daily bread. We thank God so much. We are learning so much on this platform. And I hope you and I will set our agenda this year, that this year I am going to eat the word of God. I am going to stay in the word of God. I'm going to nourish my spirit this year. This year my spirit will grow to overtake the fleshly desires that I struggle with. We thank God so much. Let us receive the blessing for the day. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for the new week, O God. Lord, a new week, a new blessing, O God. You send us a blessing every single day. This day, Lord, our hands are lifted up unto you, O God. Open the heavens and shower a special blessing unto us this day. A special blessing unto us this day that will change our stories, O God. Father, mark us for promotions this day. Mark us for your visitation this day. Mark us with your healing visitation. The Bible says at the pool of Bethesda, there was a man who had been there for 38 years. And one day Jesus visited him and healed him. Father, today we declare this day our day of visitation by Jesus Christ. Jesus visits each and every one of us this morning, Lord. And let there be a change of story in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. As we know, this program runs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Mountain Time. And we encourage you to invite family and friends. Please invite somebody. Make sure you are serving the Lord on this platform. This is your opportunity to go and call friends, invite people, and God will bless you for that. We thank God so much. Have a blessed day. God bless you so much. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. Have a blessed day. God bless you. See you all tomorrow morning. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.